from the historic Loretto Abbey Chapel. With the kind cooperation of the Toronto Catholic District School Board, the National Catholic Broadcasting Council presents the Daily TV Mass.
Welcome to the celebration of the Daily TV Mass. I'm Father Hank Van Myl. The televising of this Mass is made possible by the contribution from three donors. The first is Sabine Rosario from Vancouver, British Columbia, in loving memory of her mother, Sheila, who passed away on April 4, 2013, and for the living and deceased members of the Rosario, McLaren, Ambrose, Birdsnow, and Lopez families, for the children and family members to return to the faith, for the healing of family and friends, and for peace in the home and in the world. The second are Mary and Corrado Petullo from Etobicoke, Ontario, in loving memory of Victor and Carmen Petullo, Peggy and Tony Agnew. The third is an anonymous donor from Mississauga, Ontario, in thanksgiving for blessings received and for their personal intentions for healing, wholeness, and for grace, strength, and courage to deal with all life's obstacles. Our thanks to our donors for the gift of this Mass. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, Amen. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And as we have placed ourselves before the Lord in this time of octave of Easter, again recalling that we're not perfect and that God's guidance we need at every breath we take. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And in this time of octave, we say together, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. And let us pray. O God, who has bestowed on us paschal remedies, endow your people with heavenly gifts, so that possessed by of perfect freedom, they may rejoice in heaven over what gladdens them now on earth. True, O Lord, Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When the day of Pentecost had come, Peter, standing with the 11, raised his voice and addressed the crowd. Let the entire house of Israel know that certainty that God has made him both Lord and Messiah, this Jesus whom you crucified. Now when the people heard this, they were cut to the heart and said to Peter and to the other apostles, brothers, what should we do? Peter said to them, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, so your sins may be forgiven, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. For the promise is for you, for your children, and for all who are far away, everyone whom the Lord our God calls to him. And Peter testified with many other arguments and exhorted them, saying, save yourselves from this corrupt generation. So those who welcomed his message were baptized, and that day about 3,000 persons were added to their numbers. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Mary Magdalene stood weeping outside the tomb. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb, and she saw two angels in white sitting where the body of Jesus had been lying, one at the head and the other one at the feet. They said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "They have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him." When she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not know that it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you looking for?" Supposing him to be the gardener, she said to him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him in Hebrew, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Do not hold on to me, because I have not yet ascended to my Father. but go to my brothers and say to them, I am ascending to my Father and to your Father, and my God and your God. Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples, I have seen the Lord, and she told them that he had said these things to her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
It's a beautiful account of at the tomb. And actually, it's interesting how Jesus, in all accounts of the Gospel, came to a woman and not to a man. And just before this, Mary Magdalene had seen the stone rolled away. She gets the guys. So Peter and John run over. They look in and they see nothing and they kind of scratch their head and they leave again. But Mary, in her love, she hangs around and there she meets Jesus. And of course, first she doesn't recognize him, that it is Jesus. And it's actually a mystery that Jesus always has first showed himself to a woman. Actually, St. Ignatius of Loyola, in his spiritual exercises, goes even one step further. He claims that Jesus must have first revealed himself after the resurrection to his mother, Mary. He says it has to be. It's not scriptural, but according to Ignatius, it has to be. And that makes perfect sense. But it is a mystery. It's a mystery that God comes to us and shows us his ways. And of course, in the first reading of Acts, after the resurrection, we're already here at Pentecost all of a sudden, and the Holy Spirit comes, and Peter the chicken all of a sudden has all the courage, and Peter becomes really the true leader of this proto-Christian church, and he preaches, and of course, that day, as it says, 3,000 were added to the flock, so to speak. But it is a mystery, and people try to understand, but you never can understand. So often people come to me and they say, this or that happened to me, and they say, I don't understand, I have to understand, usually in the context of their suffering, but also in the context of when something spiritually happens to them, they have a deep spiritual experience, and they say, I don't understand. And of course you don't understand. If you understood, you're probably God. But it's a mystery, and so we can unpack it, and we can search for it, and so on, and we try to do all kinds of work, but we never will understand. We never will understand. Our faith is not about some scientific endeavor, and we can explain everything. No, we have to accept. We just have to accept and to be comfortable in living in the mystery of God. And living in the mystery of God is so important. Accept the things which we cannot understand. It's part of our living. I like science. I'm not a scientist, but I like science. It's a little bit like science proclaims more or less, or they try to proclaim, that they have all the answers and that everything can be figured out. But even if you look at, they talk about black matter. Nobody knows what black matter is. Scientists don't know, but they know that it keeps the universe together. It's a big force in the universe and they cannot explain it. It becomes mystical. And every time they discover one more thing, then another 100 questions open up. And this is our faith too. We can spend a lifetime on trying to figure it out, but really we cannot. We just have to accept. And when we really start to see with those open eyes, when we have our own little Pentecost in our lives, then everything changes. And we are open to the mystery of God. We can live in that mystery, and we embrace that mystery. And yes, sometimes we get answers, but God will give us the answers when we need it. We don't have to all figure it out, because there will be no end to it. And as We can read many books, but it just gives us a headache, or we can do many studies and it just gives us a headache. To live in that mystery is so important, and to trust that God is there at work, that the risen Christ is at work in our lives. Today, also on the universal calendar, we have the memorial of Francis of Paola. He was a mystic. His parents could not have children. They prayed to Saint Francis for a long time, and eventually they had a boy, Francis, and they eventually also had a few more children. But this praying, trusting that God would bring good out of their suffering, just patiently trusting. And Francis of Paola is one of those mysteries too. At the age, the parents promised him to the Franciscans basically. At age 13 he entered. At age 20 he was already a hermit and he was attracting followers. We cannot explain it. In worldly ways, this man is crazy, but in spiritual ways, this is the Holy Spirit at work, the Spirit of Pentecost, who is at work and continues to call each one of us, each one of us, each in our own unique way as we go along this life journey. We just have to accept and open our eyes. Amen. So let us bring our prayers before the Lord. We pray for all those in our daily TV Mass prayer intention book. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
This Easter season, we offer our community prayer in thanksgiving for the new life that is ours in the risen Christ. May we be strengthened by his healing presence among us, so that we might live in peace and glorify him by our life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
With Pope Francis, we pray that the dignity and immense value of women be recognized in every culture, and for the end of discrimination that they experience in different parts of the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray that all those who were baptized and confirmed in our faith at Easter may continue to grow in their faith, as they each build God's kingdom in their own unique way here on earth. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for these prayers, and the prayers in the silence of our own hearts, we lift them up to you, Lord. Amen. Amen. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Accept in compassion, Lord, we pray, the offerings of your family, that under your protective care they may never lose what they have received, but attain the gifts that are eternal. Through Christ, O Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But on this day, above all, to lord you yet more gloriously when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim, Holy.
Holy.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving you thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Francis, our bishop, the order of bishops, the clergy, and the entire people you have called your own. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Amen. And at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us
not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ, for the kingdom. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. May the blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Please join me now in this act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in this holy sacrament of the altar. I love you above all things, and I passionately desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my soul, so that I may unite myself wholly to you, now and forever. Amen.
And let us pray. Hear us, Almighty God, and as you have bestowed on your family the perfect grace of baptism, so prepare their hearts for the renewed reward of eternal happiness through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God.
Our thanks to our donors for the gift of this Mass.